Becomes my greatest defense. It leads me from the dry wilderness. And all I did was praise. All I did was worship. All I did was bow.
Please stand for the pledge. I
Good morning. Real quick, just to kind of a couple announcements. One, just kind of want to remind you guys a little bit. I heard there's some mixed confusion about uniforms, especially your skirts, shorts, pants. You still are required to use our two vendors, which are Sil Walter and Lands End. And then there was also a lot of conversations this week about wearing your polo shirts. Polo shirts are required every single day, even if you are wearing a jacket, sweatshirt, or sweater. So let's make sure we stay on top of that. Real quick, tomorrow is the first out-of-uniform day, so if you have not gone online to your on-campus account and filled out the form and paid on the on-uniform, you will have that opportunity to do that tonight. So if you show up tomorrow and you have not done that, you will end up getting a Thursday detention. So if you need any help with that, please come see me today, but it is on your on-campus. You will also probably receive a message today on campus if you have not done it. Please remember tomorrow for your out of uniform to pick appropriate attire to wear to school. You are not allowed to have ripped jeans, no leggings, no political attire. Short skirts, dresses need to be appropriate length. Rule of thumb, if you have to ask the question if you look appropriate to go to school, it's probably a good chance to go back in and change. So hopefully this is a great day tomorrow. We're not having too many uniform issues, so let's make sure we take care of that. If you have any questions about the uniform, dress code, please don't hesitate to come see me. All right, appreciate it. Thanks.
Hi, so my name's Blair, and I'm one of the captains for the girls lacrosse team. So if anyone who's interested in playing, we're meeting during second break right after fifth period in the small chapel. Today, during second lunch, the University of Florida will have a virtual visit in the Idea Center. The link to the visit is on the student's score account. Only 20 students will be able to attend this visit, and make sure to bring your cell phones.
National Art Honor Society dues need to be turned in by the end of October. You must turn them in during second lunch, before or after school only. The shirts are first come, first serve. And then also, there's gonna be a quick meeting during first break on Friday in Ms. Robbie's room to vote for treasurer.
Mr. Mize and Madam Sacro will travel to with Holy Trinity students to Roman Paris during spring break. There's going to be an informational meeting about this trip Wednesday, October 7th at 5:30 p.m. in the small chapel. Interested parents and students are encouraged to attend the trip meeting. For more information about the trip, visit www.htEuroTrip.com or speak to Mr. Mize or Madam Sacro.
Here's some highlights from Tiger Sports this week. Boys and girls golf will be at Suntry today, and JV and varsity volleyball will be at Rockledge. On Thursday, JV and varsity volleyball will travel to Ticeville. And on Friday, the Tiger football team will play Merritt Island against the again at home at 7 p.m. Tickets are being sold for general admission tomorrow. Go Tigers! And here's the broadcast.
Good morning, Holy Trinity. I'm Logan Mays, and this is Channel 77 News. The swim team is back in the pool preparing for their meet next week. Take a look.
Despite the unpredictability of the 2020 swim season, the Holy Trinity swim team is hard at work and preparing to do their best for the swim meets they still have.
We do have a lot of younger swimmers, but I think we're looking to do really well. The meets, we kind of have to help enforce wearing masks, but also like cheering on everyone. I'm hoping that we get to go to districts and then maybe states. That's what I'm looking forward to. For practices, we lead the stretches.
For my specific events, I've been doing a lot of technique work, so like working on my dives and flip turns and pull-outs and all that. And we've also just been doing strength training and like endurance during practice also to prepare in addition to the technique work.
Dive or belly flop?
Definitely dive.
Belly flop or dive?
Definitely belly flop.
Definitely dive.
It's time to go around campus.
This Thursday, October 1st, is the kickoff meeting of Fellowship of Christian Athletes. If you'd like to participate, it will be at 7:20 in the Tiger Cafe. There will be donuts and coffee upon your arrival.
Yearbook needs social media and summer photos. Please hashtag your Instagram photos to HTYB21 and send Snapchat memories and or TikTok screenshots. You can use the hashtag or send photos to 321-289-2787. Please be sure that all photos are school appropriate.
Seniors will be able to paint their parking spots on Saturday, October 3rd from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. Students' artwork must be approved by Dean Henderson prior to painting.
Seniors, please remember that you need to bring your own supplies and clean up after you're done.
There's a diversity council meeting today during second lunch in the Idea Center. All are welcome.
I recently got to show off my moves next to some serious ballet dancers. Take a look.
Hi, I'm Morgan Hammond and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Avery Hammond and I'm a freshman.
We've been dancing since we were 6 and 7 years old, so about 7 years now.
We do ballet every day for 14 hours a week, so that's mostly the basics of what we do.
What do you enjoy most about dancing?
Probably performing and just performing, being with our friends and expressing ourselves.
The hardest thing is looking at ourselves in the mirror every day.
Yeah.
Oh, I think they're going to do great. They have us, they're going to do great. Yeah.
Hi, I'm Logan Mays. I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Nathan Joseph. I'm a senior as well.
Hi, I'm Michael Lesser. I'm a senior.
I think I'm going to do well. I'm pretty graceful, so I think I'll do well.
I've actually been doing ballet for a while, too. I'm the most graceful thing on the planet. So is Michael behind me, too, actually. Right, Michael?
My middle name is Grace.
He was the lead dancer in the Nutcracker and in Swan Lake.
Michael taught me everything I knew.
Mm-hmm. He invented ballet.
So we're going to start off with some basic stretching.
Yeah.
Here's a tendu.
I know I got this in the bag. So easy.
Okay, we're gonna get a little bit serious now.
Pathetic.
What do you think they did?
They did great.
They did really good.
Yeah,
like really good.
Meet the participants.
The Stock Club is up and running again this year. We invested some time to check in on them.
I'm Walker Johnson. I'm the president of the Stock Market Club.
I'm Dante Valdivia, and I'm the vice president of the Stock Market Club.
So the Stock Market Club began about 3 years ago with Edward Marr, founded it when he was a junior and I was a sophomore. He really just wanted to spread knowledge about investing and the stock market with the help of Mr. Bonanza to the student body.
So with the Stock Market Club this year, me and Walker aim just to continue the legacy of Edward Marr and David Bonanza. We have a fun stock market game where all of the students that come and join our meeting, where we have meetings Wednesday in the Idea Center, just have fun, trade and invest in the stock market without spending a real penny, and just have fun as a group, collective talk, have lunch together, and just share a common interest between all of us as friends.
And that's the news. Signing off, I'm Logan Mace. Thanks for stopping by.